we are looking at reassembling or rebuilding a CV axle for the Toyota MR2. This is our original Toyota boot kit. It has outer boot, inner boot. It has clamps. And it has some containers of grease that we're actually not going to use because we're going to use a different kind of grease. And it has this cork gasket. This is the outer CV joint. This is an Rzeppa, I don't know how you say that, Rzeppa type of joint. We're just going to clean all the old grease out very thoroughly and replace it, repack it with new grease. We have cleaned the joint thoroughly and we're going to repack it with this red line CV joint grease. We're going to use this plastic tool to scoop grease out of the container and pack it into the joint. We'll go all around, changing the angle. Okay, and we'll get grease in every part of this CV joint. Pack it in. Okay, so that's about good enough right there. We take the new outer boot, put a little bit of dab of grease around it, make it slip on easier. We put a little dab of grease on this side, and we can slip it right onto the joint. We make sure it is seated all the way around. Make sure it is well seated all the way around. We wipe off any excess grease. Now we're ready to put the clamps back on. We have four clamps that came with the kit. Two are obviously for the small end, and the longest one, this one, is for the outer joint, for the big end. Take the clamp and set it in the groove. Now, here's a little trick to doing this. You have a little edge that can come free, and it matches up against this nubbin. So you match it up on the nubbin, and then it's just a matter of applying pressure. Apply uniform pressure. And I don't know, maybe there's a tool for doing this, but you keep applying pressure until the end sits right between the two flanges, and then bend them down with a screwdriver. There, we got one, and get the other. Get the other. And there, that's it, that's not going anywhere. Now we do the same thing on the small end with one of the shorter clamps. So make sure this is seated in the correct position in the groove. Put this on the right way. There we go. All that remains is to bend these flanges. Get one. Get the other. Go. Let's finish up assembling this CV shaft. The outer joint is assembled, clamped. So we're doing the inner joint. We start by slipping the boot over, slip it over the axle, over the shaft. And of course, even though it has been greased, it's putting up a fight, which is okay. Alright, so now it has snapped into position. Now we have the axle supported in a vise, and we're going to take the CV joint that we assembled previously, and we're going to slip it over the spline. And we support the joint with the boot so it does not fall out. Now, this inner race has to slip down far enough so that the groove in the shaft is showing and we can put the spring clip on it. So to drive it down a little further, we just tap it gently with a hammer. Just a few gentle taps. There, we're good to go. This is our brand new spring clip that came with the kit, with the boot repair kit from Toyota, and this is the spring clip plier tool. So let's see if we can get this to work. We keep our fingers over the spring clip so it does not go flying. Slowly we spread it apart. There. The next step is to pack the CV joint with grease. We've already put some grease in from the bottom, and now we just add grease from the top. The next step is to get the boot on properly, and with all this grease, you'd think that it's not too hard. There we go. Okay, to clamp this boot, it's the same as for the outer boot. We have the short clamp that goes on the narrow end. It has this little lever mechanism We wrap it around. We get the lever. We get the lever over this nubbin. Then we just have to support. We just have to support it so it does not rotate around on us. Oh, I missed the nubbin there. Just have to make sure it's over the nubbin. There. And once it goes over the nubbin, make sure it's engaged in the two tabs. We bend one tab and we bend the other tab. There we go. Hope you can see that. Both tabs are bent down. And the clamp is secure. Okay, let's do the same thing with the long one. The long one also has the lever. Slip the clamp over. Engage the lever with the nubbin. Okay, engage the lever with the nubbin. Support. Let me get the proper leverage here. There we go. Okay, so engage the lever with the nubbin. Support the strap. And bend it down. There we go. It pops when it's ready. Now we can bend the two tabs. One tab done. Let's get the second tab. Okay, so both tabs are done. Let's secure them nicely. There. Okay, so we have finished the assembly of this half shaft. Outer joint, inner joint. There's one more thing. There's the cork gasket that goes around the mating surface with the stub. And let's see how we're going to take care of that. The CV joint is now resting on top of the vise, and the assembly is pulled down into the outer race. And this is going to let me clean off all this excess grease up here. Gonna clean it all off. And I'm even gonna take this rag and douse it with, I'm gonna take this rag and douse it with some brake clean so I can get better cleaning. Just have to clean this top surface. I do not want to get brake clean into the grease. So I just wipe the top surface. With this rag. And get it as clean as possible. This is a gasket sealant adhesive. We're going to apply a very sparing amount. We're going to apply a very small amount of this stuff to this top surface in some select spots. Just where it can go on without any risk of getting into the grease at these. So just put it on at these wide spots. So this is the gasket that goes in here. It matches up to the bolt holes, and it comes with a pressure sensitive adhesive. See if we can put this on and make it stay. So there we go. That is securely adhered to the race, and it's not going to fall off when we go and put it back in the car against the stub. This joint is completely reassembled and it's ready to go back in the car. Thank you for watching.